The segregation within crypto caused by blockchain tribalism has made it difficult to interact with multiple blockchains at the same time. In the rapidly evolving world of blockchain technology, interoperability has become a key issue of different blockchain networks struggle to communicate with each other. This has led to a great deal of so-called blockchain tribalism, and this has seen users segregate into different fractions behind different L1 blockchains, as well as the formation of independent ecosystems operating on each chain, with a huge amount of redundancy and also copycatting. This, unfortunately, has also made it more difficult for end users to interact with the most useful decentralized applications and protocols, since they would need to manage independent wallets for each chain they wish to interact with. Enter layer 1 blockchains, such as Polkadot and Cosmos. These offer a solution to this problem by enabling cross-chain communication and also interoperability, helping to produce a more cohesive blockchain ecosystem. What is a layer 0 blockchain? Well, layer zeros are blockchains that aim to facilitate the seamless exchange of data and or value between otherwise independent blockchains, potentially including layer 1 and layer 2 platforms. Right now, most blockchains are siloed off from one another, and each maintains its own ledger, its own set of smart contracts, and in many cases, its own user base due to blockchain tribalism. This leads to a major duplication of efforts, with many dApp developers opting to deploy their smart contracts on multiple different blockchains, potentially dividing their community and introducing UI hurdles. It also leads to the rapid growth of clones and also copycats, which take the formulas and products that already succeeded on one chain before deploying them on a separate chain. And this has led to somewhat predatory strategies, with layer ones competing for popular decentralized applications or dApps and putting up sizable ecosystem funds to help draw in talent while striking up exclusivity deals with prominent dApps. Layer zeros change the paradigm by helping developers favor cooperation over the competition by ensuring that the applications and products they develop on one chain can communicate and interoperate with assets and users that exist on other chains. The way they accomplish this can vary considerably between platforms, ranging from full-blown interoperability protocols like Polkadot's Substrate Framework to more modular solutions like Cosmos Inter-Blockchain Communication or IBC protocol. By creating a network of connected blockchains, Layer Zeros aim to break down the walls between different blockchain networks and promote a more collaborative and interoperable ecosystem. This could potentially unlock new opportunities for innovation and also development, as well as greater efficiency and scalability in the blockchain industry. It can also help to power novel use cases that take advantage of the unique properties of multiple different blockchains. As the blockchain space continues to evolve and also mature, Layer Zeros will likely play a crucial role in enabling the seamless exchange of data and also value between different blockchain networks. So, how do Layer Zeros work? Well, the layer zero landscape is now incredibly diverse, with well over a dozen platforms now vying to become the thread that closes the gaps between blockchains. These all aim to connect different blockchains together to form a more cohesive and also interoperable ecosystem where cross-chain communication is simple and efficient. But the way they attempt to accomplish this varies from platform to platform. That said, there are some common underlying techniques, principles, protocols, and also technologies that most of the platforms use. And some of these include atomic swaps. So layer zero blockchains use atomic swaps to move assets from one chain to another without the need for a trusted intermediary. Atomic swaps enable use cases like cross-chain liquidity pools and also interchain asset trading. And then there's also cross-chain data oracles. So these allow blockchains to securely access and leverage reliable off-chain data and allow independent layer ones and layer twos to access information from a variety of different chains. Moreover, platforms like Chainlink offer interoperability protocols like the cross-chain interoperability protocol or CCIP to help blockchains receive and exchange data from Oracle nodes in a standardized way. And then there is arbitrary message passing. So practically all layer zeros feature a way to pass arbitrary messages between chains, allowing for seamless data exchange between any and all chains in the L0 space. Some examples of arbitrary message passing technologies and protocols include Polkadot's cross consensus message format or XCM, WanChain's cross-chain communication protocol, and also Cosmos SDK inter-blockchain communication protocol. And then there's also shared consensus. So by offering a single underlying consensus mechanism for all associated chains, layer zeros can massively improve efficiency and maximize the utilization of available resources. This can also lead to improved security by supporting a larger and more diverse validator network, which some independent chains would only be able to achieve with help. And then there's also bridges. So the vast majority of interoperability platforms leverage bridges, which use a combination of smart contracts contracts and APIs to facilitate communication between two or more chains and can be implemented in a variety of ways, including through centralized or decentralized mechanisms. Assets or data moved between chains can then be used with an expanded range of platforms and also protocols. Then there's also shared security. So many layer zero blockchains offer a shared security resource to connected chains, allowing them to bootstrap their node or miner network and remain secure even if they are relatively small or inactive. And Polkadot's relay chain is a prominent example. By leasing a parachain slot, parachains can benefit from the central security offered by validators operating on the relay chain.